Thank you for joining us. The Municipal Asset Management Program is delivered by the Federation of Canadian Municipalities and funded by the Government of Canada. The purpose of this webinar is to go over FCM's Asset Management Readiness Scale, a tool that helps local governments self-assess and measure progress on their asset management program. You will find this webinar most useful if you have FCM's Asset Management Readiness Scale open in front of you. You can find it on FCM's website at the link on your screen. Note that this version of the Readiness Scale has been updated since its original launch and was republished on October 23, 2018. You will gain the most value from this presentation by following along in the updated version.
Today we are going to go over the five competencies that make up FCM's Asset Management Readiness Scale and the levels and outcomes within each competency. We'll discuss how to assess your community against the Readiness Scale and how to use the results to make progress in asset management. If you are a grant recipient of the Municipal Asset Management Program, you will also hear about how the Readiness Scale relates to your final report requirements. You may also have encountered the Readiness Scale during training activities around the country, where partner organizations of the program show participants how to conduct self-assessments.
The Asset Management Readiness Scale is a tool that allows any community to assess their state of asset management capacity using common metrics. It helps the community assess where they are and can help identify the areas they need to work on. The Readiness Scale is made up of five different building blocks, or competencies, which, together, form the practice of asset management. Find them on page 4 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale document. They include policy and governance, people and leadership, data and information, planning and decision making, and contribution to asset management practice. Each of these five competencies is key for sustainable service delivery.
In the Asset Management Readiness Scale document, you will see that each of these competency areas has its own table. The table you see on this slide is the competency table for policy and governance. There are three parts to each table, which we will explain now, and are also described on page 5 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale. Levels, which are across the top of the table, outcome areas, which are down the left-hand side of the table, and outcomes, which make up the body of the table.
Let's start with the levels. Each of the five competency areas is organized on a progressive scale of five levels. You'll see each of the five levels at the top of the competency table. In general, the levels demonstrate progress along a maturity model construct. Pre-level 1 and level 1 are focused on initial investigation into the competency. The middle levels of the scale are about integrating processes and systems into daily routines, and level 4 and level 5 are focused on regular monitoring and continuous improvement.
Next, let's consider the three outcome areas, which you can see on the left-hand side of the competency table as blocks A, B, and C. These outcome areas represent important components of the competency that a community would need to work on. For example, for policy and governance, the outcome areas are policy and objectives, strategy and roadmap, and measurement and monitoring.
Finally, let's look at the outcomes. For each level and outcome area, there is at least one outcome indicated. We've included checkboxes as an easy way to keep track of the outcomes that your municipality has achieved. The outcomes describe important steps in building asset management practices in your community, and they will be your focus as you conduct a self-assessment using the Asset Management Readiness Scale.
Now that you know about the different parts of the Asset Management Readiness Scale, let's talk about how to use it to conduct a self-assessment. Page 6 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale document describes this in more detail. It is important that this exercise be conducted as an organization-wide assessment and not one focused on only one area or department. First, bring together a cross-functional team of staff from the departments that are relevant to your asset management practices, not just to one asset class. They should represent an understanding of finance, decision-making, and the planning and operations of each relevant service. If you're part of a small organization without formal departments, this may just be the CAO and the Public Works Manager, for example. Then work together with your team to read through the competency tables and develop a common understanding of each outcome. It is important to note that you can start with the competency that resonates the most with your team. You do not need to go through the competencies in a specific order. They all work together. Discuss your organization's current state in relation to each outcome. Identify what you have already achieved. After this discussion, select the outcomes that describe where your organization is at that moment. You may have activities coming up that mean you will achieve some of the outcomes imminently. Do not take those into account when doing your self-assessment. Only once an outcome is part of your municipality's normal practices should you consider that outcome achieved. You will use the outcomes that you have selected to determine your overall readiness level for each competency.
It is important to note that in order to be at any readiness level in a competency, you need to have achieved each of the three outcome areas for that level. For example, if you have achieved each of the outcomes under Level 3 for Policy and Governance, you can say that you have completed Level 3 for Policy and Governance.
However, if you have achieved Level 3 outcomes in one or two of the outcome areas and a Level 2 outcome in the remaining outcome area, you would assess your readiness level as the lower of the two levels. In other words, as the level in which your municipality has achieved all of the outcomes. In this case, you would say that you have completed Level 2 for Policy and Governance because that is the highest level for which you have achieved all of the outcomes. Let's take a closer look at each of the five competency areas that you will go through as a team in order to conduct your self-assessment, found on pages 8 to 15 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale document.
By developing the policy and governance competency, your organization is putting in place policies and objectives related to asset management, bringing those policies to life through a strategy and roadmap, and then measuring progress and monitoring implementation over time. This competency is meant to assess your organization's commitment to embedding asset management into your decision-making processes and merging it with your long-term objectives and strategy.
Let's look at what the policy and governance competency might look like for a community with a population of 500 who are at the beginning of their asset management journey. They might describe their current actions as having not yet developed a specific asset management policy or asset management objectives. Perhaps, though, they have developed a methodology for developing a policy and are in a position where they need senior management approval to begin. That is approximately the level of detail that will be helpful to determine and justify your current state and readiness level. In this case, where the municipality has not yet achieved all of the three outcome areas in Level 1 in the competency, they would have assessed themselves overall at the working on Level 1 readiness level.
The second competency is people and leadership. By developing the people and leadership competency, your organization is setting up cross-functional teams with clear accountability and ensuring adequate resourcing and commitment from senior management and elected officials to advance asset management practices.
The third competency is data and information. By developing this competency, your organization is collecting and using asset data, performance data, and financial information to support effective management, planning, and decision-making for your assets. This competency helps you improve your data management practices so that you have the information you need about your assets when you need it.
The fourth competency is planning and decision-making. By developing this competency, your organization is documenting and standardizing how the organization sets asset management priorities, conducts capital and operations and maintenance planning, and decides on budgets. You may notice that many of the outcomes in each competency are complementary or relevant to those in other competencies. For example, in order to make good decisions as part of this competency, you need to have strong data on hand, which is accomplished through the previous competency, and which is enhanced by regular review, update, addition, and confirmation. This speaks to how the competencies build on one another, and how each of the competencies is key to sustainable service delivery.
Let's look at what the planning and decision-making competency might look like for a municipality with a population of 10,000 who have started their asset management journey. They might have a regimented business planning process that includes the decisions they make on asset investment. They assess themselves at readiness level 3 in the documentation and standardization outcome area. They have used their asset management program to develop investments, but do not have a long-term asset management plan. They assess themselves at readiness level 1 in the asset management plan's outcome area. Their annual budget is based on a multi-year tactical plan, and all capital investments are identified in it. Operational budgeting is based partially on strategic maintenance practices to extend the life of assets and represent a mixture of historical values and new priorities. They assess themselves at readiness level 3 in the budgets and financial planning outcomes area. With one outcome area assessed at level 1 and two outcome areas assessed at level 3, the municipality determines that their overall readiness level in the planning and decision-making competency is level 1.
The fifth and final competency is contribution to asset management practices. By developing this competency, your organization is supporting staff in asset management training, sharing knowledge internally to communicate the benefits of asset management, and participating in external knowledge sharing.
Once you've gone through all of the competencies and outcomes and have thought about what your organization has achieved to date, it will then be time to record and document your self-assessment on pages 17 to 19 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale document. This section of the readiness scale is there for you to record your readiness level for each outcome area and competency, as well as to describe your current actions. Once you have documented your current state, the tables offer space to document potential actions for improvements, where some meaningful discussion can take place about what you can do to progress to the next readiness level.
Here are a few notes to consider based on the experience of communities across the country who have used this scale to assess their asset management practices. You'll get the most out of the readiness scale by taking the time to work through it as a team and thinking critically about where your organization is today. Assessing yourself at a lower level does not mean that you are not managing your assets, only that there are ways to formalize and ingrain your asset management program within your organization. Over-assessing your organization's achievement will make it more difficult to understand where you should focus your efforts, resources, and funding. It may also make it more difficult to identify areas of progress as you improve, or communicate to staff and council the need for continued improvement. There is no need to progress through each competency to the same level. You may be much further along in some competencies than in others. Your organization may also choose to aim for higher levels in some competencies than in others. For example, your community may aspire to reach level 3 in data and information, level 4 in planning and decision making, and level 2 in policy and governance. Keep in mind that level 4 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale is roughly aligned with the requirements of the ISO 55000 standard, which is a significant accomplishment. It may not be necessary for your municipality to achieve the higher levels in the scale in order to meet the needs of your community.
The results of your self-assessment on the Asset Management Readiness Scale can be used to support your community's asset management practices in the following ways. Identify priority areas of improvement to help you plan for staff time and resource allocation. Design initiatives to improve asset management practices based on which outcomes you want to work on. Track your progress over time so you know if your activities are helping you improve or if you need to make some adjustments. Report on the achievement of outcomes to a variety of stakeholders, the internal team, CAO, council, or funders. And finally, use the shared language of the Asset Management Readiness Scale to talk to other municipalities about where they are and what they did to get there.
If you received a MAMP grant, then you'll be familiar with the Asset Management Readiness Scale, since you would have completed your baseline assessment when submitting your application. It is important to note that you will be asked to complete the Readiness Scale a second time at the very end of your project. Whenever you are assessing your organization against the Readiness Scale, regardless of whether you're at the beginning or at the end of a project, you should be assessing your current state of your organization at the time of the assessment. And future actions or results should not be taken into account at that stage. If you participated in a training event offered by a partner organization, you may have used or are using the Asset Management Readiness Scale to conduct current and end state assessments as well.
The Asset Management Readiness Scale was developed as part of FCM's Municipal Asset Management Program. Are you at the very beginning of your asset management journey? Do you want to learn more about concrete steps that you can take to reach level 1 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale? Check out FCM's guidance document, The Building Blocks of Asset Management, a how-to guide for reaching level 1 of the Asset Management Readiness Scale at fcm.ca. FCM also hosts a variety of resources related to different components of asset management on FCM's website. Get in touch with a community of practice. They are a great way to find support in asset management. You can find a list of Canadian Asset Management Communities of Practice at Asset Management Canada's website, www.assetmanagementcanada.ca. If your community's asset management practices are underway, but you want to dig deeper into certain concepts or understand how asset management documents work together, we recommend FCM's How to Develop an Asset Management Policy, Strategy, and Governance Framework, published in 2018 at fcm.ca.
We thank you for taking the time to learn about FCM's Asset Management Readiness Scale, and we welcome any questions or comments you have about the tool or how to use it. Please direct any feedback to mamp-pgam@fcm.ca.